Hey guys, my name is Scoby. Today I'm going to be showing you how to play Sega 32x games on your Android device. This is going to be a nice, quick and easy tutorial. On screen right now you can see me playing some Knuckles. Let's jump right into this. So the first thing I want to do is open up your Play Store, and we're going to be searching for and installing Retro Game Center. Now Retro Game Center is going to be the emulator we're going to be using to play Sega 32x games on our Android device. What you want to do is get this installed. And while you're on your Play Store, we're also going to be backing out, or we're going to be installing one other application. We're going to be searching for and installing Z Archiver. We're going to be using Z Archiver a little bit later to extract and use our games. Z Archiver is 100% free. It works similar to WinRAR or 7-Zip for PC, but I'd recommend having this regardless for other emulators and for a bunch of other things. It's great for managing stuff on your phone, so get both of these installed. Once both of these installed, the first thing you want to do is open up Retro Game Center for the first time. If this is your first time opening up the software, you may have to allow access to your phone storage. You are going to need to do this because a little bit later on we're going to be needing to locate to where our games are. So this is the UI for this software. It's kind of clean and it works really, really well. We're going to be getting into more of the specifics later on once we have the game set up. But if we click on our menu on the top right, first thing we're going to be doing is coming into our settings. We can change a couple of different things here. We can change the image width and the text size. These are the main things you can do with these settings. You can reset them by clicking the box on the right. And that's pretty much all we can do with the settings. If we go back to the browse section, we can search for games here and we can link the games. I'm going to be showing you how to link the games in a second. But what I'd recommend doing is backing out of this, going to Z Archiver and creating a new folder by clicking on the three dots on the top right, clicking create, and then create a new folder named Sega 32X or whatever you'd like to name it. I already have one created down here, which is Sega 32X, where I put all of my games. And this is where I'd recommend putting all of your games. To move any games, all you have to do is long press with Z Archiver, click copy, locate to wherever you want to put them, and then click the green box in the bottom right. And that's how you copy your games to wherever you want to move them to with Z Archiver. I'd recommend doing this. It just helps with organization a little bit. Now, the only time we're going to want to extract our games is when games come in a .7z file. If they come in a .zip, it'll be no problem for our emulator to open them up. But if they come in a .7z or a .winrar file, what we're going to have to do is click on them and then click extract here, which will extract all the files of our game out. Now we are going to need these later on if you want to link them to our emulator. I'm also going to mention now that I'm not going to be showing you in today's video where to download games, but games are really, really easy to find. A quick Google search will help you out. But once you have this done, you've created a new folder for all your games. We're going to be backing out and going back to our emulator. And from here, what we're going to want to do is search for whatever game you've currently downloaded. Now you cannot actually download games in this emulator. Despite how it kind of looks, it suggests that you have to search for the games once you have them downloaded to link them to the game in this emulator. So I'm going to be searching for Star Wars because I have a Star Wars game downloaded for the Sega 32X. And if we search this here, we're going to be able to link it to our actual file by clicking into our game. We can click link ROM right here. All you want to do is locate to where your game is. As you can tell, I have StarWars.zip right here. Click on it. The game will automatically link. And then to play your game, all you need to do is click play game. You can start from the beginning or resume from where you were. You can relink the file if you wish. If this file does not work, you can download it from another source and relink it. What I'm going to be doing is starting from the beginning, and your game will run as simple as that. And it's as easy as that to play Sega 32X games on your Android device. This emulator works really, really well, and it's a really nice emulator to use. You can close down and open up your on-screen buttons with the arrows down here at the top and bottom. We can close down our game by clicking the power button on the top. And once you have your games linked with the emulator, we can really easily find all linked games by clicking menu on the top right, clicking play on the top left, and then it'll show all currently linked games, which is really, really nice. We can easily click on whatever game we want, resume from last time or start beginning. In this case, I'm going to be resuming from where I was last time, and it works really, really well. This is the best Sega 32X emulator I found. It's the easiest to set up, and it's the cleanest between the UI and the whole linking system. It's really, really nice to use, and I'd really recommend it. Anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this tutorial, be sure to drop a like. Subscribe if you're new. Check out the other videos on the channel. I'm going to leave a link down below to my PayPal if you found this video helpful and you want to support me. Of course, there's no pressure if you can't. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, as always, keep it saucy. Peace.